Okay, we're going to start working on the chapter 12 chapter examinations questions, and I'm going to work through each of these. There are about 20 questions, and the last question, there are three parts to it, and we're going to omit the last part. But as you look through these questions, these are good problems to practice for chapter 12. I just want you to realize that chapter 12 deals with children's doses, which are basically the same concept as far as adult doses. This is basically a review of everything we've been doing all semester. So let's go ahead and get started. And the first one says, read the label in your figure. How many milligrams will the patient receive per day if the physician's order is for erythromycin, 50 milligrams per kilogram per day, in equally divided doses if the patient weighs 32 kilograms, and it's equally divided doses every 6 hours. So to get started, I'm going to realize that I have an order of 50 milligrams per kilogram. And the per day says this is how much you would get in 1 day. And then I notice that the doctor's order, well, it's based on weight. So I'm going to need to start with the patient's weight. So if I want to get how many milligrams, I'm going to start with the patient's weight, and then I'm going to multiply it by the doctor's order. And notice I'm going to specifically put the 1 kilogram on the bottom and 50 milligrams on top so that my dimensional analysis will work out. Now also notice I'm left in milligrams, so this would tell me an answer of 1,600 milligrams. And remember, this is in 1 day. Okay, so how many milligrams will a patient receive per day? Well, the patient will receive 1,600 milligrams per day. So that's all we need to give for that answer. Now B says, how many teaspoons would you administer? And you would think about this being a reasonable thing for children, only because you don't ask children to swallow tablets and capsules just yet. You might have more of a liquid dose. So then we're going to have some kind of strength, whether it's given as a percent like we did in chapter 8, or just a different strength that's just specifically written on the label. But there's usually some kind of liquid measurement that we're going to give. And so a lot of times you will be administering teaspoons. Now the other thing that I want you to realize is that you are looking for one dose, not 1 day. So when I get ready to do this, I'm going to look at the fact that I have 1600 milligrams in 1 day, and the fact that this medicine is administered every 6 hours, which means I will have 4 doses in 1 day. So that means the 1600 milligrams needs to be divided equally into 4 doses, and I'm looking at 400 milligrams in each dose. Now what I'm going to realize is, okay, take the 400 milligrams and let's get teaspoons from that. And right now I'm still in a dry measurement, so I've got to go to my label to see if there's anything that will help me figure out how to get to a liquid measurement. And when you read the label, you see that 200 milligrams is the same thing as 5 milliliters. And so they tell you that's how much erythromycin you have, and it's 5 milliliters reconstituted. Well, the other thing is we want an answer in teaspoons, and I would go back to my conversion sheet and figure out that 5 milliliters is 1 teaspoon. And so when I work all this out and my dimensional analysis does check out, everything ends up and I'm with teaspoons as my final answer, I end up with 2 teaspoons. And remember, this represents in 1 dose. Okay. Now number 2. This one says the physician's order for a 2-year-old is Tylenol, 150 milligrams by mouth every 4 hours as needed for pain. The label on the bottle of infant's Tylenol suspension drops reads 80 milligrams per 8/10 of a milliliter. We're going to mark the dropper, and also once we mark it, it's going to show how many milliliters we are going to administer to this patient. And so I notice again I have the doctor's order of 150 milligrams. And then I notice that the label told us 80 milligrams is found with 0.8 milliliters, so you have 8/10 of a milliliter of liquid and you'll have 80 milligrams of medicine. Now this will leave you in milliliters, so you can stop right here and you will come up with a calculation of 1.5 milliliters. And when you draw your arrow, when you're looking at the syringe, notice that the syringe had tenths marks basically, or excuse me, half marks. So this was 0.5. It's a little hard to see on the sheet, but this was 1. This was 1.5. Well, obviously, we would draw our arrow at 1.5 milliliters. Okay. Number 3, it says the physician order reads Ceftin, 20 milligrams per kilogram per day, by mouth every 12 hours. The child weighs 40 kilograms. How many milliliters of Ceftin will you give the child if the label reads 125 milligrams per 5 milliliters? Now I notice back again, I've got the order in 20 milligrams per kilogram per day, but that just means this is how much I get in one day. Now they did ask me, how many milliliters will you give the child? We have to assume that they're talking about one dose, and this was done every 12 hours. So that means I'm looking at a total of 2 doses during the day, and I have to divide evenly the 20 milligrams by 2 to get 10 milligrams in one dose. Well, then if I have 10 milligrams in one dose, I know that's based on kilograms, so I better start with the patient's weight. And 1 kilogram will get 10 milligrams of medicine. And then we have the label that reads 125 milligrams in 5 milliliters. And my dimensional analysis will check out. I'll end up with milliliters, which is the answer that I'm asked to give. How many milliliters would you give? So this turns out to be 16 milliliters in one dose. Okay. Number 4. So the prescriber has ordered this Sublimaze, 2 micrograms per kilogram, IM 30 minutes before surgery. The label reads on the vial 50 micrograms per milliliter. How many milliliters would you administer to a child whose weight is 30 kilograms? Notice another one, we have an order based on weight, so we better start with the child's weight first, 30 kilograms. And then the order says each kilogram will get 2 micrograms of medicine. But then I can use the label, which has 50 micrograms found in 1 milliliter, and then that will leave me with milliliters when I cancel my units. So I'll end up with a final answer of 1.2 milliliters. Number 5, it says a child is being treated with Platinol AQ. Twenty milligrams per square meter, IV daily for 5 days for metastatic cancer. If the child's BSA is 0.6 square meters, how many milligrams should this child receive? 0.6 square meters is a BSA that has already been calculated for us. We don't have to do that on our own. And the doctor's order says every square meter will get 20 milligrams of medicine. When you do this calculation, you end up with 12 milligrams that need to be administered. Number 6 is very similar. It's a physician who's ordered Matulane, 100 milligrams per square meter by mouth daily. How many milligrams of this drug would you prepare for a child whose BSA is 0.93 square meters? So anytime I have the patient's weight or the patient's BSA, I usually start there, because the order is going to be based on their weight or their BSA. This time I end up with 93 milligrams. Now number 7 is very similar. 7 says a child's BSA is 1.1 square meters, and if a prescribed drug is ordered at 45 milligrams per square meter, how many milligrams would this child receive? Okay, so anytime you have BSA, go ahead and start with that first and then use the doctor's order. Now number eight also has a BSA in it, Decadron. 9 milligrams per square meter by mouth daily in 4 equally divided doses. That has been ordered for a child with a BSA of 1.04 square meters. And if we start off like we did just before, we're asked how many milligrams of the steroid should this child receive. I'll use the order, but I do want to remember in the background that this order is based on the entire day. So when I look at this answer of 9.36 milligrams, this is in 4 equally divided doses, so I need to divide this by 4, and I will end up with approximately 2.3 milligrams found in just one dose. So number 8 had a little bit of something extra, but very similar to the previous examples.